What is up, everyone? This is Prasanna Balakrishnan back again, and this is your review of Porto nil, Chelsea 2. Chelsea with a very good win in the first leg of the Champions League quarterfinals against FC Porto. We are in absolute prime position to qualify for the semi-finals. The second leg is next week. It's also going to happen in Seville, but let's get into it straight. We went with the conventional 3-4-2-1. Havertz with false nine position, Mount coming in, Chilwell coming in, Rudiger coming in, and Christensen coming in. Those were actually some changes before we had to make after Saturday's humiliating defeat at the hands of West Bromwich Albion at home. So Chelsea started well. We did start well. First 10 minutes, we had possession. We were passing the ball out well, but we lacked the cutting edge. And Porto eventually came into the game. They came in without two of their key performers, striker Mehdi Taremi, and their leading scorer, Sergio Oliveira, who was suspended for the first leg. But Porto created many chances, but we defended very well. Our defense was much better than it was on Saturday, and it had to be better, else Porto would have gone at least to score maybe one or even two goals. We were very sloppy in the front third. Our lack of cutting edge was clearly evident, as you saw Porto clearly setting up as they defended deep and they were looking to counter-attack. But we were still, for a team like Chelsea and the attacking talent that we have, you expect us to do better. And Porto, clearly, they pressed us from the front and they had most of the ball and they had also chances. Overall, we had the higher possession, as we can clearly see here. 60% possession we had, but they had 12 shots, out of which 5 were on target. We had just 6 shots, out of which 3 were on target and 2 we were able to convert. The other stats, they had 9 corners to our 4. We made 9 tackles to their 7, and we were caught offside just 2 times, but they were caught offside 4 times. So, at the start of the game, as I mentioned, we did start well, but towards the game, when the game progressed, actually they were better. They created chances. Our defense was up to the mark. We had some clearances we had to do. We had some nasty defending we had need to do. And Cesar Azpilicueta put in a true captain's performance today. He was absolutely brilliant today. Christensen was very good today. Rudiger was absolutely brilliant today, apart from that one mistake in the second half. And eventually, we got the goal. It was a wonderful ball by Jorginho. Wonderful pass. And then Mason Mount, wonderful turn off on the Porto defender. Clinical finish into the bottom corner. And that was 1-0 Chelsea. And we made it in the 32nd minute. That was the goal we needed, just to calm a few nerves. And we somehow rode the wave till halftime. And halftime, we went in 1-0 up. Second half, you're thinking Chelsea should come out of the second half much better, because first half, we were pretty poor, even though we got the goal. Second half, we did come out much better. We played our football. There were substitutions made. Pulisic came on. Giroud came on. And that kind of, you can say, I won't say kind of changed the game, but you could see pretty much attacking threat was very much added, you can say. We missed a very, very easy chance. Rudiger had a long shot and it was spilled by the goalkeeper, but Werner was on the rebound. He was quick on the rebound. And Havertz, I still don't know how he missed that open chance. You could say he was caught clipped from behind by Pepe, but replays did show that Werner was offside. So even if Havertz scored, would that have been counted? But still, you are not to know until the whistle is blown. You're told play to the whistle. But they were substituted off. And even then, we had a glorious chance of a corner. Reece James with a, not a corner, it's a free kick. Reece James with a brilliant free kick, and Azpilicueta got in goal side. And it was a diving header. I don't know how he missed. He should have at least hit it on target. Even if he hit it on target, it was a clear goal. He kind of dived in and he got too much power on the header. And not to mention, I forgot to mention Werner's missed chance in the first half. It was not a beautiful clip ball by Werner. Mason Mount at the edge of the area. Werner got to it, but again, he drove his header away. I still don't know what he needs to score the goal, but he's trying and trying and trying. Second half, we kind of sucked in. We were kind of, at one point, we bought on Kante. It was kind of, I would say, we were kind of going for it, but in the back of Tuchel's mind, he was kind of thinking 1-0 is enough, we can take this back to the bridge. And eventually we did go for the second goal. Pulisic was in goal and he rattled the woodwork. This could have made it 2-0, but eventually he made it 2-0. Chilwell capitalizing on a mistake by the FC Porto defender, calmly rounding the goalkeeper, and he made it 2-0. And Chelsea go on to win. Finally, it's another clean sheet, something that did happen against West Brom, sadly, but it happened today. We're back to keeping clean. Rudiger is back. So another clean sheet. Coincidence? I think not. But you see what Rudiger brings to the team. That's what Zuma should be learning. He is new. He will definitely come up good, but Zuma, he does make some mistakes out of which he has to learn. Pretty decent performance by Chelsea. Even though Porto had many shots, I don't think many of them hardly troubled Mendy. His easiest save was parrying a header. It was a comfortable height for him, but I don't think any save that he had to make. He had to make a pretty extraordinary save or anything like that. It was nothing of that sort. Pretty calm and composed in defense. And we had three shots on target and we put two of them away. And we are now in prime position. We have one foot in the semi-final of the Champions League. And hopefully we can make it. We can do the job next week when it comes to the second leg in Seville. We have Crystal Palace coming up this weekend. Hopefully we can bounce back, get 3 points, because we dropped United. They beat Wolverhampton Wanderers yesterday, day before yesterday, sorry. So I expect a reaction from Chelsea in our post top four. We will definitely go for a Champions League as well. We also got the FA Cup semi-final to deal with. And let's see how it goes from here. But for now, I'm pretty happy. Do like and subscribe to this channel. Like this video. Share to as many Chelsea fan friends as you want. Subscribe to my channel, Prasanna Balakrishnan. It's been picking up well for the last few days. I've now got 65 subscribers. Let's make it 100 pretty soon. See you after the Crystal Palace review. Up the Chelsea.